not to say it on the mainstream, but we're here on the second stream, and on the second stream there's a little bit more freedom. You'll never know, but you viewers, you guys who are watching right now, you know. We're just giving Machine shit, but he's
asking me. I'm not giving him shit, I just like the term anti-strat. What's wrong with that?
Anti-strat does sound nice.
So it's gonna be a punch ban, I don't know if that sounds nice to you.
No, I hate that. I love their punch. I always loved the OG when they, like when they first started playing together with this new roster. They would run the hookers, so they'd run the clockwork as well as the punch.
What?
The two heroes with
hooks. Okay, the punch and the clock.
Yes, the punch and the clock. It became a thing, all right.
Right. So OG is gonna get their Earth Spirit again this time, probably.
Ooh,
Earth Spirit Warlock. This is like a super good counter against Batrider. And talk about the hookers. Dotwork is on Advin this time.
Yep.
It's a very good hero at killing Luna in the early game. Because of the cast time, when you get Luna alone, Hookshot and Battery Assault, the Luna can never cast his Eclipse, her Eclipse, because of the cast point. So it's a very good hero at killing the Luna at the start of the game, but it's not that great later on when she has a lot of items.
Yeah, and Luna wins at everything. But that's kind of Luna anyway.
I mean, I guess it's a support battle, yeah, so he won't get his levels that quickly because of the Batrider. I'm not sure if the team runs mid Batrider. I know some teams do that, but it's very rare nowadays.
Get away with it. Like, you can still run like SD and Clockwork as a support combo, because that's the more old-fashioned one. You get Clockwork level 2, then Disruption Catcher.
I mean, the main reason why would you do a Clock... There's two reasons why would you do a Clockwork support. Number one, you're trying to throw the enemy off their draft, because they don't expect a support Clockwork.
Yeah.
Number two is you're trying to abuse the cogs for the Shadow Fiend. Because when you do a support clockwork, number one, you give the Shadowfiend damage, and number two, you're gonna cogs the offlane. It's the same reason I was talking about where you pick a support Earthshaker, like what Advin did in this previous game.
Like SF though, in this game, appears very risky to attempt.
Yeah, I'm just trying to understand and explain what could be the possible.
Why you do it?
Why you're doing it? They're actually not gonna go for the Earth Spirit. Earth Spirit Warlock combo, really, really potent. They're going to actually get the Rubick instead, which is a hero that can deal with the Batrider and Clockwork very well.
Yeah.
Instant lift when he comes into Lasso, and you can remove the Clockwork out of his cogs with the lift, so a really good hero against...
So you actually get a counter before you have to buy something like a 4 star.
Mm-hmm. And Advin goes for... Okay, they're gonna go for a very big carry since they went for a Puck plus Batrider duel. Called like your offlane and mid lane are heroes that are mainly creating space. Look, if you look at the first four heroes, AM would be a very good ban, like, because if you want an AM, you want to pick an AM game, these four heroes are great at complementing AM. Yeah, another good option would be like a Morphling SD. I think Morphling SD would be pretty good hero.
You could definitely turn the Lunar against yourself with both SD and the Morphling working together.
Yep. So that could be a good option for them, and it's a big hero, so they definitely want that kind of hero. A hero that will soak up the whole map's farm and just carry your team.
The only concern is they still don't know who the mid is for OG.
There's a lot of options possible. I mean, you mostly see Nyx offlane, but I know Nyx, some teams like to play, but I'm not saying it's like
it would make sense if you had like the Batrider and like some kind of heavy intel.
DK, huh?
Yes.
Taking out their staple heroes in the series. And right now, what is the big hero? We mentioned Morphling.
Can you get something like the Invoker pick up for OG? Does it work against Advin and Planum?
Still possible, because you have the Nyx running around, so if you have Sunstrike, it's going to be really good for Nyx to get pickoffs. That could be a possible option, and you're looking to push with the Luna plus Warlock, you have Fort Spirits. So I think that would be a possible option for OG. And right now, Advin for their big... A big carry, so apart from Morphling, there's still the Sven. Sven is pretty good at dealing with the Warlock Inferno, since you kill it in like what, 2-3 shots. That could also be a possible option. Other options, I'm not sure if we've seen, I think maybe we've seen one Spectre game. I think Spectre is a hero that could be utilized in specific situations like this, where you fight with the Puck and the Batrider. But I would still prefer much like a standard, like a Morphling.
The concern for Spectre is you may not have enough space created by...
And your lane is going to be very difficult, so that's
the
part that I dislike about Spectre the most. But what other options are there apart from
this? Did you go through the PA option?
I don't really like PA here, honestly, because it doesn't. He's not a, like a hero that can take all the farm, and he's not a hero that utilizes the disruption very well. So, if they do, Alchemist would be weird because of the laning phase. Oh, they go for the Jug, so I'm not sure if that's gonna mean a Battle Fury Jug. Because if you're playing a one row Jug, you want a go for Battle Fury. You take the whole map.
You can't need to have that to deal with mass lunar.
The Juggernauts that we've seen yesterday and today are mostly just meta diffuser, because there's usually Dokos, so the Juggernaut is allowed to be more active and be more participative in the game. You don't really want to go for the Battle Fury build when you have two cores, but this game I would consider the Battle Fury on Juggernaut.
So I want to see how this clockwork's really going to pay off for them. Mm-hmm. Even the Pock rotations, like...
possible dual lane maybe. Clockwork plus Bear Rider dual lane. Like, you can trap the enemy, like the supports or the Luna and the Cobbs. And the Firefly on top of that, that's a lot of damage with the battery itself. So I could see the dual lane potentially working for Advent. And right now for OG, they're going to need, like, you know, you mentioned the Invoker would be a pretty nice final pick for them. You have
I'm just sticking crowd control.
Invoker, it's pretty good crowd control when it goes to late game with your Deafening Blast. But the Alchemist. So that we were actually right at the start of here. Why would they want Radiant? They're gonna need like some alchemy, some Naga hero, you know, to farm the jungle. I mean, right now
we were right before this draft even began.
This pick means that it's gonna put a lot of pressure on Athena. Because when you're playing against the Alchemist and you have just one carry, you have Juggernaut. It's a soul carry.
But you don't have good rotating supports to try and shut him down, mate. Is this...
The Alchemist is gonna be...
I think it was Vega in the European qualifiers. At the very, very start, when they went against Radiant Alchemist, they went in and they just kept warding. And like it was like three wards to cover the two close camps. Yeah. Yep. And they always had a support there.
They don't really have the right heroes to pressure the Alchemist, so I think I kind of will expect the Alchemist to get a lot of farm. And he's up against a very good matchup. Alchemist against Putt doesn't really have the tools to, you know...
Right.
Generally, when you see Alchemist being pressured in the lane, he's against a Timber, he's against a Ursa. Heroes that can kill him in the lane, but against Puck, if he plays his cards right, it's going to be very difficult for the Puck to get a kill in the laning phase. So,
alright, quick predictions. First player to get 50 last hits, do you go with the Alk stack?
You have to do this, okay, Alchemist.
Is the Alk?
Which team will win? OG Dota 2.
It looks which pretty good for OG.
Last player to be killed, Alchemist.
Wait, really?
He's never going to be killed. Oh, okay, actually I messed up what that actually meant. Last player to be killed, probably a support. Shadow Demon. Team with the most runes picked up by 10 minutes.
I'm gonna disagree with you and say it's not SD.
Teams with the most runes, okay, they have Alchemist.
I'm saying it's Fly.
Okay, they have Alchemist, they're gonna pick up the runes, so OG.
Well, unless Advent try and contest it, remember they are gonna run this dual lane kind of thing. Yeah, so...
Okay, YOLO, OG. They're gonna pick up the runes.
By 10 minutes?
Alchemist is gonna get 5 bounty runes.
I'm disagreeing with you and saying Advent is gonna be hot on the money, protecting the runes but not controlling the camps.
But right now, because OG has a much greedier lineup, it's gonna put all the pressure on Advent. They have to be the team that's always on the lookout to make a move, trying to kill, trying to steal a stack, plays an aggressive ward. This is what Alchemist picks does to you. You know, it puts you on a time bomb. That's why it's so annoying, you know, when you pick it at the right situation and you want to pick it in a game where you feel like you can get away with it.
Can you actually, like, because I'm wondering, even if they do walk over and they manage to get, like clock at level 6, he comes over and he ganks the Alchemist, can you even control the jungle? Like,
yeah.
this is a juggernaut where you normally can push with healing ball. You don't really have a great push lineup.
I think OG doesn't really have a... the reason I say greedy is because when usually you run Alchemist lineup with a Luna, you're really greedy and you want a 4-role hero that can actually defend the stacks. You see this usually done with Undying, because when you're stacking, you have the tomb there to protect you from... You always expect the enemy to pressure you and try to steal your stack. So you have the hero like Undying to protect your stacks with Tombstone. But right now, I don't see that kind of hero. Like, Warlock pre-level 6 can't really defend the stacks very well. Same goes for Rubick.
Mm-hmm.
So if the pressure, like you mentioned, like if the pressure comes early, they make an early rotation to place wards, and you're in like a pre-level 6 territory for the Warlock and Rubick, that's gonna be the risky part and the dangerous part for OG. If they can survive that part, they clear the stacks, they get level 6 on the Warlock, game would be really, really nice for them.
This is actually a nice little thing for AF. They scouted out the observable beam place thanks to the smoke maneuver of maybe next time. So they're giving just passed a sentry ward over.
Oh, they gave it to the clockwork, the 100 gold?
Yep.
Come on.
I'm wondering what exactly for.
I mean, I guess it's fine. They just didn't want to run. Usually you want to give it to the mid laner, but Tug is all the way on the top side of the map, so they probably felt, eh, I'm not going
to
waste it.
They're actually looking to go for that top rune.
But OG has the numbers here. So
yeah,
they
Madara does have spin. That could cause a couple of problems, but no talent.
Oh, he's yours. He's going
for Madara, heavy damage. Juras gets to pick up. Madara starts spin. Physical damage. May do the work. Alchemist. He got the bounty rune. So the Skylark S4. He has the stun. He's going to find Madara in the tree line. He has not been moved up or down. No, he does. He's got the observable there. But no, the stun from S4. Out of position. No talent's moving up. So he's still here with the damage output. But maybe next time with cogs, maybe able to isolate that Luna.
Okay,
but
so
will not happen. They're retreating back out, and they're switching S4 now down to the bot lane. OG's, he's gonna be very
OG is doing the same thing. Aggressive lane with the Luna. Luna's blessing allows you to do that very, very well. And Nyx,
mid lane. He doesn't have acid spray. Lux is taking a little bit of damage from the creep wave.
Okay.
And Anna gets back in range of the T1.
This is definitely not something you see every day. A level 1 Harris by Clockwork, support Clockwork. But bottom lane S4 will be up against a solo bat. As Nyx.
They're actually switching it, bad sleeving. He's TPing top, Madara's come to the bot lane.
Madara can't really farm very well in this lane, so they're choosing to prioritize his farm. Because Bear can easily jungle, which is, I think, the right call considering everything right now for Effinan. And looking at the Alchemist Siege, despite the pressure, I still foresee the Alchemist getting really good farm from the lane.
Alchemist drive. Like,
yeah,
like the old phrase of Alchemist was, you pick up a bounty when you've already won mid lane. that was the old way of looking at the Alchemist.
Who said that?
That was the phrase going around in the last TI.
I mean, it's true. I mean, it's
bottom lane, S4's in trouble. He has Spike Carapace available. And in fact, yeah, now he levels it up. Spike Carapace will trigger. Obviously, Madara's protected by the spin. TP's arriving in from the Warlock. From Jirax.
They need to trap him in the cogs to get that kill there. So, rather unfortunate. Or maybe
how do you actually
time
not get that? Like, that's like you just dropped into maybe next time
it's,
walking
it's
in.
A bit weird though, because, you know, they changed the formation of the cogs.
Yeah,
it used
so
to be square. And now it's like, a circle, which is, I don't know, I played some Clockwork games after they changed it. I feel like it's always weird. I feel like I get the enemy. I feel like I'm going to get the enemy, but for some reason it doesn't trap him in the cogs. So, I mean, that's rather unfortunate. Missed opportunity there for Effinan, but Madara still farming pretty well after the lane swap. So, I think all things considered, he's still pretty happy at the general state of things.
Here they go, another TP's coming. SC, but oh wait, no, the SD. TP might have been cancelled on the bottom lane. Anna fighting underneath his own acid spray. He's doing a lot of damage to maybe next time. Same for Thug. Remember, he got the arcane range before this began, so that's why he has another acid spray already
and
ready to go.
Manchu really just allowing Anna to tank up the damage. It's such a great item on all those melee heroes that go mid, and we see a TP. Luna on no tail.
They want Madara. Or maybe Jirax wants something else through Spartan into the creep army, and now with the stun from S4, Spin's looking for some revenge as Clockwork might get killed up by a neutral. Spartan gets away. Spin's down for Madara, so where did Clock? He just denied himself up in here.
Just typical first 5 minute things, you know. Supports dying to Ancient, supports dying to Roshan, supports dying to neutrals.
This is still looking pretty damn good.
Oh, that's another one.
He's dropping like that. The CS is still, like, it was looking pretty good for AF in the following game one. It was actually looking very, very good for them.
Oh.
The net worth's not out of control for an
Puck
Alchemist.
Is actually,
he's got 9 last hits and he's still on level.
Yeah, Puck is actually 11 CS ahead, but that's because of the Clockwork doing his shenanigans earlier, like pressuring the Alk. Like you said, as long as you're getting the bounty runes, you're Gucci.
Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, he's only got one of them, so. You got a bounty, and he's got an arcane.
The dream is to get 5 at minute 10.
That would be a dream. We live in the world of reality. Especially your world,
but
Mr.
Still,
Analyst.
Dude, it's still not wrong to dream, you know? We have to have dreams, you know? Goals!
You are
a fortune cookie, I know what
you're
gonna say.
Yeah, you know exactly where we're going with it.
I am a fortune cookie.
I just say it, like, guys, I asked Goz to create the new BTS brand around winter, where you can now buy like winter fortune cookies. And it comes with one of the most obvious yet meaningful lines ever. Winter sayings.
Okay, in the meantime, Epinen is smoked up. They're trying to get a pickup here with the SD plus Clockwork. Disrupt into Cogs. Hopefully, they are not going to mess it up again this time. They really need to put the pressure onto OG since they are the team running the Alchemist lineup.
So Alex waiting for it. Here's your opportunity. Fly moves out, and now Battery Assault will begin. Pick up from Georyx will make this a little bit more difficult for Skylark. Okay, now they got Disruption too. Lock around. Notar can't really help. Flies in a world of hurt. And that's actually the first blood. It has taken 4.5 minutes to get there, but Adfinim have managed to spill it when it's on the support Warlock.
And they are moving in. Do they have wards? Are they going to place wards? Yes, they have a ward on the Clockwork. So this is what you are talking about. Against the Alchemist, you need to invade the jungle, place wards. So far, no stacks available yet for the Alchemist, but they're going to try to surround him.
Yeah, they're going to go on for the mid lane fight. Still under the Acid Spray, Thug. Losing life, so is Spartan. The Cogs will be planted down, so Ana is trapped. No TP supports on the way. The
Orb will hit.
They move through the Cogs, and then Ana runs up, then runs back down again. The body block from the SD illusions. It'll do the work.
That was such a hard kill for them. Like, those heroes don't really deal a lot of damage at this stage.
And now they're going to lose their offlane. Skylark's out just a little bit. Actually, are they? Well, there's not enough damage from Notel. He's got the mana for a Lucent Beam, but there's no ultimate for him yet. Nonetheless, Skylark wants to really hang around with Pain of Bonds.
Oh, another kill to the new. That was like number 4?
Yeah, something like that.
The last player to be killed. Oh, so that's what it means. The last person to die.
It was the last player. Yeah, the last person to die, but I don't know if that actually counts deaths from neutrals.
Apparently it counts. Yeah.
Okay. Last player to be killed. Okay. I was wrong. I had Fly.
But that's at the end of the game. It's still updating throughout the game.
Yes.
So, Bounty Rune, yes. Ana gets a Bounty Rune, so that's my number 2. I'm not gonna be...
We just count it. We're just now count Winchilla. 2!
Spartan gets a Disruption onto S-Bot, Omni Slash.
Oh, the Spy Carapace, that doesn't create enough space. That still needs to last longer on Madara for S-Bot to get away from the range of the Blade Fury.
Good kill though, nevertheless, getting a core kill there with the Omni Slash. Once you get that online, you want to put it on cooldown, getting a kill on the Juggernaut. And, you know, like I mentioned, they are running like a single Juggernaut as their main carry. No one else is going to do the physical damage, so he needs to be very huge this game.
Go again, bottom lane. No tell, the flame break. I can't push and clock back close enough.
And here comes S4. Rotation is not too good if he doesn't get anything. He still hasn't gotten his level 6 yet.
It's a little premature, Carapace? So he's going to spy Carapace to actually stun him thanks to the Firefly. But the Bonds will tie him in too, so meanwhile the Alchemist is dying in mid lane. We'll watch Skylark running for his life on the bottom. That won't work. Is there a salve trigger as well? He'll be trying to get enough life to survive again.
Still, okay. A kill. That was what I was worrying about a lot when if you TP down like this as an offlaner and you don't get anything done, it's really bad for your overall momentum. So S4 gets his level 6 and he has the double mangle, so he's gonna have the mana to get his combo Vendetta into the stun, and hopefully he gets a kill and he's gonna get his Arcane Boots. That's basically what you need in the early game as a Nyx. Just one piece of Arcane Boots and you're level 6. He's still thinking about where he should move right now. Like, he wants to stay bored, kill the bat again.
His AF is moving. They're coming in with Skylark as well as Madara.
Yeah, they're gonna barely miss.
Well, they're gonna slip in. They're gonna find Ana, but they're surrounded. S4's on his way in. So Madara doesn't actually have Omni Slash available. So Batrider, there's just done. Get the double one. Spartan's gonna come in to help him out, but the Fatal Bonds connects all of AF together. So Notel, this Eclipse is gonna do some serious lifting. Two of them down. Respect the Warlock or suffer the consequences. Skylark's on the run, at least maybe Thug can play this one out. Georyx has telekinesis available, plus he stole sticky napalm. Skylark's not gonna get close enough to the tier 2 towers. There's no damage to help him out that way.
Look at the team play. Nyx Assassin TP's bottom, gets the Luna kill, and Luna TP's to help them out in return. This is the kind of play that you want to have if you want to be a tier 1 team. it's not all, when you're playing carry, it's not only about your team helping you, it's all about giving back to your team as well. That move literally put OG in such a good position. That Eclipse just gained so much out of them. Like, they were like a little bit behind, but right now, secured the Alchemist, his farm, and he's gonna be, you know, on his way to his armlet.
Coming in for another moment here. Disruption from Spot. Supports have already left, so no tell for that TP, for the assistance he gave to the rest of his teammates. He ends up dying.
They actually didn't use Lasso in the fight.
Nope.
Alright, so he might have not been expecting that. So.
I think for most of that fight, they were just trying to run away.
Yeah, he kind of...
Like, once they got faintly bonded up, that was a
nightmare. Forward state is welcome, but right now, S4 is on the prowl once again with Vendetta. This is a difficult kill to get, because it's very hard to land your Vendetta strike, plus the stun. Unless he lifts and initiates for the next, okay.
Oh, I think Fly knew that one was coming. He threw the sentry down. He wants the last hit though. Whoops, hang on, that wasn't right.
That was actually not right. I was looking at a screen.
Yeah. It looked wrong, right? Like the attack didn't look like it hit the ward. But he couldn't attack anything else. Bottom lane, maybe next time. Doesn't have level 6 yet. He's still short by 50 experience.
You can see like the movements of AF right now. They are really, really like nervous about... They know they need to make a play. They know that they are on a time bomb because they're against Alchemist. Like, mm-hmm. Their movements are really, really under a lot of pressure. They need to get stuff done when they move. They need to stop the Alchemist.
Nortel, Skylark? TP's coming in. Nortel's going to get the losing beam off S4. Can I actually hope the Firefly was still
Where's your Firefly?
Still up.
Yeah, where's your
He thought it was going to be here. TP's down, and now he's surrounded by 5 heroes. AF brought the whole enchilada to the bottom lane.
Okay, so I think S4 overall, he's still doing the right thing. He's just constantly trying to make space. Because when you're in a draft where you have Alchemist and Luna, you know, you know as a offlaner, you're not going to get much in the game.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to have to get your levels. I think the only thing he needs, like I mentioned, just one pair of Arcane Boots and go. That's the only thing he needs. He's trying to set up a kill on Thug.
He wants AF to come back and defend this lane. So yeah, they start on Thug. TP's coming in. Remember, Fly has the Chaotic Offering. Drops it. Wanted that Puck dead so quickly. The first TP got cancelled, and the second one will also be cancelled along with it.
That was a very good rock, because they're going to be able to get that tower as well. Like,
I was wondering if you would want to wait just that little bit longer, though. Are you actually wait for AF to come back and fight you?
I mean, I think it's fine, because once the Puck is down, it's very hard for them, and the rock is already there. They're already having the numbers advantage. Difficult for them to defend the tower. They're still trying to defend here. So, it seems like they're going to be able to hold, maybe even deny the tower with the catapult still, you know, laying onto the tier 1 there. Should be able to deny the tower. So, I mean, all in all, it's still not all bad for AF despite giving out that kill.
As if they actually kill the catapult.
Top lane. They have the veil on the park with the call.
Well, they managed to get Lethal Dream for a lot. Chemical Race.
Oh, Jarrett!
Time, and wow! He actually managed to steal it! And return it into AF, maybe next time. Has to stand his ground. He cannot chase. Skylark might be able to get something in return, but no, it's actually S4 and Vendetta. Walking underneath Spartan Sentry for a short moment.
Man, Jarrett is such a great player. Like, play after play after play. This guy just doesn't cease to amaze, like, what he can do. Just at the right place at the right time. Like, Alchemist dying there would have been really bad for OG. He was on his way saving up already. Oh, he's gonna get caught!
Oh yeah, he will still die. Concoction's being prepared. Lasso means he's actually gonna stun himself. Denial, if he toggles it...
Shut up. Alright, it's difficult.
Yeah.
I mean, it's difficult.
Top lane, S4, looking for his opening. Finds Thug, Madara's in the lane.
Oops.
S4 actually was starting to go for the stun. Madara not going to be baited into his Blade Fury.
So Madara actually went for, he's not going to go for the Battle Freedom. Just going to go back for that aggressive Manta defusal build. So this is going to mean that they're going to be all on the aggression. They're not even going to try to play into the farming game. Alright, some players go for the Yasha and then the Battle 3, but don't see it that much nowadays. It's mostly just the Diffusal plus Manta build.
Do you like this type of build when you're running an Alchemist against an SD to still go for Radiance?
I think it's fine though. Like,
you're not worried about the copies?
No, I'm not really worried about the copies because all I have to do this game as OG is to get farm and reach. Yeah, then I'm gonna be winning the game with my Alchemist. You can make illusions of Alchemist, but I still have Luna. And as long as they play the farm game, I don't think AF has what it takes to, you know, beat them in the late game situation. That's why you could see, like, the past few minutes, AF were really, like, concerned about making a move.
They want Ana again. Flies in the nade.
Where is Rubik?
He has better bonds as well as the Rock, so there goes your Rock and the better bonds. Hookshot comes in from maybe next time, but under the T1 tower, the Balrog is already down, and that's gonna be a very dead clockwork. Fly gets
coil.
The double kill. Jirax still with the coil up, holding Spartan in position. He'll take the stun, but no Talisman range to lose a beam. Jirax with Fade Bolt as well. He'll find the kill.
Oh,
three heroes down for AF. They thought they had it, but they fought into Chaotic Offering.
Once again, like, OG at the right place at the right time. With I have to commend No Tails carry play. Like, such a team player. Like, he knew that he needed to focus on helping the Alchemist more this game, because AF are going to be putting a lot of effort into trying to shut down and pressure the Alchemist instead of pressuring the Luna. And he's just always at the right place at the right time, dropping his Eclipse. This is his second Eclipse of the game, but I think both his Eclipses have been really, really important at securing the Alchemist's early game, like his farm, especially not dying twice. That was really, really crucial for him. And not to mention the Rock on top of that.
No Tail still grows his hair.
Oh yeah, he has different color on the player introduction and his actual color.
Yeah, like that looks very much like Steven.
Kobe just always fascinated with the cosmetics.
It's the little things. The little things.
Yeah, sure, Toby. The little things.
What's like Jimmy the first time, right? You check out like this evil. You know what this actually reminds me of? Like the original Kingdom Blade.
You know what I like to do when I'm paused?
Like the real Doombringer.
The real Doom.
Oh, look at the back
of it. Yeah, you're right. The Dota 1 Doombringer.
Yeah.
So old school.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm sorry. Like this is
old school and cosmetic
this
lover.
This is Sentinel and Scourge, bro.
Old school and cosmetic lover. Those two things don't go too.
That's what we got. So it's still off for the Radiance, even though 7.3k, 7.4k net worth the Alchemist.
He's still been slowed down significantly up with all those deaths. A usual standard Alchemist game.
But he's still so far in front.
Yeah, you get it like 14 to 15. Like, that would be average timing. It's like 14, 15.
And here comes AF again. Like, they're looking for the Alc.
Yeah, like I say, they are really feeling nervous about the Alc pick, and they're... Remember all these moves that AF have made? They have not done it with the Batrider Blink, they are just running at them.
Oh, Anna's farming, Jirax will put down the Observer and Sentry, that's why they can see this coming. Jirax gonna steal Disruption, so if he needs to, can actually save Anna.
Rubik with Disruption again, and he has Luna and Alchemist on his team. This is gonna be the dream spell to steal.
Speaking of Luna, like, okay. I get her Luna now, she's got Dragonlance and like she got a couple of buffs. She used to be like one of the most fragile Agi cores in the game, but
yeah, that's what
she's by herself at the T2 tower.
Yeah, that's what I've been talking about sometimes. Certain heroes are really good in the meta not because the hero is really strong, but because of the item builds available for the hero that makes the hero good. Like, Terrorblade was quite popular before because of the change to Dragonlance where you have all the stats for agility and strength. Just like you say, the small things, you know, the small things matter.
That they do.
And right now, AF are gonna secure a tier 2 at bottom. But in the meantime, OG is getting farmed in the mid lane, they're farming the top lane, they're really happy with this trade, and they are gonna pressure the top.
I'm wondering if AF actually wanna fight this, because they push the clock right up
Rock,
here very
Rock
early
is
on.
Coming online though, fighting into Rock is
14 seconds.
Yeah, it's generally not a good idea.
Yeah, they're TPing over, OG won't fight it. They've already finished their rating, so this
yeah,
is just
they're
like
just waiting for their Rock though. I think if OG waits for the Rock and Rock's online, they get a good Rock plus Eclipse, like Rock, Fatal Bond,
fight.
Rock, Fatal Bond, Eclipse, they're gonna win the fight.
Why? Because she's still got Disruption, right? So hey, why not push?
They're gonna run in, they're gonna smoke up, try to find an initiation with S4, or even bait the Alchemist. Jump on my Alchemist, AF, OG says, and we have the Rock.
Anna just starts to start, okay, you already faced out the Blade Fury. 15 seconds without that, S4's in the back lines, the Cogs from maybe next time, push him away, S4. Not in position to get the Summon Madara because
that was such
of it.
A good dust there by maybe next time. Understanding that Juggernaut already used his spin, Nyx might be trying to set up a kill, pops the dust there, and gets the Cox to save Madara's life. But still, AF is in a very, very precarious position right now. They
it's
have to.
Gold off the Blink Deck of the Skylark, too.
They have to win a they really have to like make a big play, win a fight. Like even though it's against a warlock, they have to do it because the longer they wait, it's gonna get harder. Alchemist is just gonna pull ahead and get more levels and farm, and the game is gonna be difficult. Batrider daggers, like, they need to make something. Do they have any smokes available?
They've been spending a hell of a lot.
Do they have one more? I think they have one more soon. Like in 2 minutes.
It's, 2:40. 2:40 until they have a smoke. There's nothing on the heroes, just dust. Yeah, is there anything on courier?
This is getting very tense for AF. If nothing happens in the next few minutes, game is going to be extremely hard because they didn't go for a battle fury on Jug, they went for the fighting build. And with OG's lineup having Alchemist and Luna, their late game is more or less secured.
Mana's going to buy up the BTs before he gets into the Mana style. So they at least won't have to worry about the illusions pushing down the lanes just yet. Oh, unless they're created by the Rubik, but he's lost his disruption now.
And OG is also looking to fight because, like I said, even though they have the Gridia lineup, that because of the Warlock pick allows them to be deep right now because Warlock is really strong at fighting the early stages. And just look at AF, they're just running away. Yep. They're running away from the Gridia team because they can't team fight.
Where is S4 going? He's underneath the sentry ward at the moment, so he's gotta be careful. It's still in range, still in vision. Now he's out of range. They trigger off the dust, blink lasso. And this is gonna be Nyx Assassin S4. Just held position, Spike Carapace wants to turn for the stun, but thanks to Sticky Napalm, that turn rate just too long, so he couldn't get the double stun and get away.
So talk about turn rate. Jack Hero has probably the worst run right now. If you get Sticky Napalm, it takes ages for you to turn.
Oh, with two heads, like, you're not really that aerodynamic for a dragon. And one of the dragons always has his mouth open, like, you catch so much air and you get drag.
Sure, that's the reason why.
Yeah, if only Jakira could find the slipstream.
In case everyone doesn't know, Bobby's secretly a Jakira fan.
What do you mean secretly?
He hopes that Jakira's gonna get picked every game.
You know what my happiest meta was? When you had Io Bristleback offlane, Jakira one position safe lane.
What? Yep. Oh, that was like Fnatic, the old Fnatic.
It was Team Empire, actually. Team Empire was doing that. Fnatic did it a little bit too. But Team Empire did it because they had BZZ on the core. And then they would just run it. So Jakira would pressure the bottom lane with Liquid Fire.
When you talk about...
And then you had like this mass damage, physical damage, because you got level 6 on the Bristleback. And you would take both tier 1 towers. And there was no way you could fight. You have to pick one or the other to fight or defend. I mean, like, I just killed Jakira, who was really freaking tanky.
S4 finds the SD?
The Spartan...
Okay, he's dead.
Spartan was twitching.
Yeah, but when you talk about BZZ, all I think of is his Pugnasad.
Wow. What a great way to remember a fantastic player. The shittiest set in the game.
I have so many of the set, that's why I remember.
It's because everyone had the set. It kept dropping. It's Crystal Maiden's Wheel of Fortune! What am I gonna get in this? It's a BZZ Pugnasat! You get a Pugnasat, and you get a Pugnasat! Everybody gets a Pugnasat! Thanks, BZZ! Yeah. Simply too much. That Mantis almost done on Adam. It seems like only yesterday you're picking up the PT. What's up there, little, like... Like Sniggers, you're just like sniggering away.
I bet.
So we get a hand of Midas for Thug. Got Blink, got Veil, goes into Midas. This is like almost like 2 years old.
I'm starting to realize the game is getting into late game, whether they like it or not. They're not going to be able to force and push high ground anymore. But still, I think it's going to be super difficult, like it's definitely going to be really difficult for them in the late game stage. And if you look at the other heroes as well, like all four of the heroes on OG side apart from the Alchemist are great Aghanim Scepter heroes. You buy one for the Nyx, you buy one for the Rubik.
Everyone's happy to have one. You buy it for the Luna. And she then goes Refresher Orb and...
And then you lose the game. I mean, don't get me wrong, I think the Ags Luna is great. Just that extra step for the Ags Luna, the Refresher was too all in, and newbie just got BKBs, and oh, you have Refresher? No Butterfly? Great, I have BKB. So right now,
Nortel's got a Haste Spoon.
Things are still
getting... He's gonna run Thug down. Gearax, with his Blink Dagger, just jumps in, controls the puck. And he stole Waning Rift. Because he silences the
Because of the Waning Rift that got that kill. I mean, Jerax is just... I don't know, man. This guy is just one of the best 4-0 players.
Alright, right, can they kill Ana?
They're back up though. Warlock's behind Ana.
No, they got no Firefly.
Yeah, Warlock's behind anyway, so it's gonna be a very difficult and risky kill, so they back off. They TP out, but every minute they waste, the game just becomes harder and harder for AF, so... Roshan... If they can at least secure the Roshan, it might be really important for AF to prevent. If OG gets the Roshan on the other hand, game is gonna be...
TP. Dara, do you want to hit that? Anna's back! Spartan, he gets him cocked up, goes to the disruptions, at least get the copy of
Anna,
but then there's more of them!
Oh, he dodged Omni's Slash!
Oh, even the couriers are gonna go down too!
Oh my god, he dodged the Omni Slash and he's taunting away there.
alright, is he still good?
It's Gucci. Obi, he is
Australia, fun. Australia, we love you, Australia! Hurrah!
Secretly supporting newbie and OG because they both of the teams have an Australian.
The team's now Australian, man. Australia can't succeed in anything else apart from commentators. Yeah. So when Anna as well as KP actually start doing something, yeah, Australia all the way.
And you're same if the
team. Do we even have Australia?
You're same if the people that call Faceless a European team because of black.
because it's a German.
Just because they have one Australian.
I'll take what I can get. Back. Middle lane, Madara, Jurax again! He still has the silence and then he steals the spin. They got nothing to stun the Juggernaut, however. With a Mana Sail, he can actually break free of the silencing rift. But Jurax couldn't get the easy kill on that.
You know, this Rubick is just... I don't know what to say about this guy. He's just always making plays everywhere. It's very difficult to do what he's doing. When you're watching, it feels, oh, he's just like doing Rubick stuff. But in practice, it's very difficult to do what he's doing. Always at the right place at the right time. And as for... You know, he's just playing the sacrificial role this time. You see his net worth. He's actually the support of the game. But he's doing the right thing. Like, as a Nyx, when you're... when you're in a game with Luna, Alchemist, and you have a Rubick, like a support that can push out the lanes, you ideally want to do that, and you do not want to, you know, be in the lanes too far.
Dream call, Thugs ain't ever crack, no tells, like, oh, bring it, fight me if you can. Thug doesn't get hit by most of the Eclipse, thanks to a phase shift.
Small victory, Eclipse wasted, so see if AF can capitalize on that.
You've still got to give respect to Chaotic Offering.
That was the downfall of them in the last two fights where Motel got a really, really big Eclipse off.
Can S4
find him here?
There's a lot of heroes here for OG.
He needs his team over. He needs the Warlock to be here to follow up.
Thanks to the Observer Ward, they know the Spartan's not positioned just yet. S4's pretty close behind Madara. Thug trying to scout out with the orb.
His team is too far away.
Yeah.
Not sure if they
can
follow
up. He's
to
be careful too, not to come underneath the sentry ward.
Do they have a gem?
Not yet.
No. Probably should want to get one, actually. But then again, the Batrider wants to get a BKB against Nyx, so it's a really tough call here. Need a BKB against the Carapace and the instant Rubick lift.
So casually, Alchemist walks to the side shop, picks up an Octarine Call, and back into the tier 2 tower in mid, bottom. Touches his own concoction stun with the Manta. And he can make a whole bunch of copies of himself, however, thanks to Spartan going to work. But Illusion's very quickly mopped up by OG. But the trade-off is a bit.
Time for Rubick to steal Disruption, Toby. And here comes Jerax tipping to the mid lane to try and set up for his
team. Only got spin, however, so gets through in the healing ward to start with. And
bottom lane, they're gonna go in bottom.
TP's out.
Bottom lane.
Concoction doesn't get stunned. Actually dodged this time from out of the four stuff to get him out far enough. And it's four! The triple's done! Absolutely perfect! The Radiance Burn is still
on the
Carapace. It just reaches him by Carapace. They get his hookshots off target. As Anna is bailing out after that buyback that came out from Thug, he still wants to break free. Mana Sail cooldown in half a second. And now Madara, concoction prepares, the rock will drop, and AF underneath their own tier 2 tower, not just losing 4, they had the buyback out from the puck.
That's gotta be game right there. That was so big for OG there, and now they're gonna get potentially one lane of Rex here with the Alchemist plus Luna lineup.
Well, there are other options. They just rotate for the top lane. It's the only lane where the tier 2 tower has dropped. So
yeah,
they can force
that
another
lane. That is actually possible. They get the mini Rex and they move top lane.
Okay, S4. He's already moving in position for Spartan. They pick him up. Tyrax with that blink dagger is always on the front lines, and he stole level 4 disruption.
Gosh.
With that Luna. There is more no tell where that came from. They create a whole bunch of alchemists. They're leaving. At least one of them is. Ana is going back to the mid lane.
I mean, the safe play would be just to kill Roshan and then proceed for the kill after you get the Aegis on the Luna or the alchemist.
I suppose you do have the disruption, right? So you probably feel confident enough just to go through mid anyway.
I mean, getting this is like the last thing you want the Ruby to steal. This is the last thing you want him to steal. Gosh, this is bad for them. The game is more or less really close to over for Adfinum. They need to try and make
smoking.
A play. They have to try and make a play, a Hail Mary. One last ditch of effort. Try to get an initiation onto, like, Warlock Golem's down. They need to initiate on the Alchemist or the Luna and get a quick kill with the Omni Slash right away.
But the smoke didn't work. They can't get out. Another 3 minutes until the next smoke is
done. If they're not fighting without the Warlock Golem, they are not fighting when Warlock has Golem. That's basically it. If they're not trying to fight now, they're not going to be able to fight.
You might still do it anyway. Like, you still got that BKB out. Ana doesn't really give a crap. Blink, Blast Zone, the disruption is there. That was T-Rex doing it. So there's more coming up, and with the Eclipse from Notel, maybe next time tanks a lot of it. Still with that hookshot of Valve, they're trying to get back out again. The purge on the Alchemist makes it difficult for Ana to run, but then Concoction preparing, he's loading, and now with the... Okay, he'll just burn out eventually. So no Alchemist. Better Bond does snake up AF, but flies in the run with no rock up. OG get punished by Adfinim, and maybe they find some more 4-star flame break, no longer provide
that,
but the cops will do the work! Notel can't escape, Meister TP's, but he knows he's dead! Puck will take it, getting almost 700 gold.
Okay, I was gonna say that the safest play was to get Roshan, wait for your cooldowns go again, but...
You said it, but OG didn't do it.
OG... I mean, I don't blame them, they were in such a big lead. I would have probably called my dog, and let's just end the game. Screw the cooldowns. I mean, they got punished, so AF is gonna be rewarded with the Roshan, so that's gonna give them a lifeline in this game.
You see what AF hit him with? Practically everything in this team fight recap is packed. Everything is full.
Yep. They were just, they got caught in a really bad position because the Alchemist actually got lassoed way into the enemy base, and they did not have the rock to save him. And right now, OG. They're trying to contest the Roshan, it seems.
Really gonna come over? You got the disruption on the S4, so they'll send a whole bunch over. They get the dust early out, so S4, if he feels confident, he can move in. Roshan's very low, wait for those illusions.
Oh.
And S4 jumps in!
Oh,
he does take it! He managed to take it! They're gonna catch Skylark too as he goes for the lasso! But S4 teamed up now with Ana! They'll bring down the Shadow Demon, and lasso stolen by T-Rex! This man! God does not actually describe him enough. He grabbed the Juggernaut and pulled him back. Two heroes down, the Aegis Immortal burnt. That's not even burnt. S4 still got the bloody thing.
Okay, that's just probably most likely game as well. Like, Warlock has his Golem up this time. And Juggernaut is probably going to be forced to buy back as well.
Stat Rider. S4 does it. With the Spike Carapace gets the stun, Skylark's down, buyback used, but the SD dies because the smart Omni Slash needs to work with the hookshot ball from maybe next time. S4 swapped in the Eclipse from Notel. Watch the burn in the moonlight over the Thug, but good game. Well played. OG will take out the third, and they will top the group. Number one position for them. Their day will end. They will be very happy with their performance, even if it has been a rough one. This whole group stage has never been a two-